Good motto, my beautiful people's persons. I hope everybody is well. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Grilled. Today, we eat. Tikka Chicken seemed to have overpowered on all platforms for me to review this week, and that's what we got. We got some Tikka Chicken from Cape Town here in the southern suburbs. A lot of you mentioned Wajits, a lot of you mentioned Bilal's, a lot of you guys mentioned Altaf. I didn't know where to go in the northern suburbs, nobody said anything. Today we are going to review Arshad's Tikka Chicken in Rylands versus Ali's Tikka Chicken in Repulse Road. We're going to hit him with a 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to scream Thug Life, and we are going to enjoy this. Let the sauce sit on my back so we can lick it for later. Alright, here we go. We are gonna start with Arshad. We just simply took a quarter chicken and chips and naan bread. Just pull it apart quickly a little. Have a tasty. And then I like the best part of the chicken. We're gonna check the juice to dry ratio. We're gonna check the how much spice and how much sauce is on there. And then the chippy as well. You know, when I open this stuff, I can't help myself, I must dig in same time. No discipline! Anyway, here we have Arshad in Rylands, Ruth Road, quarter chicken breast and wing with chips and a garlic naan. Can you see it over there? There we go. Now, there's a certain way that I eat my Tikka Chicken. Just gonna break the wing off. This wing I'm gonna suck beautifully later. You know what I mean? This one. You know what I'm saying? What I do is, I normally take a piece of my garlic naan bread. Garlic naan is a bit elasticity acclaimed. Then I take some meat of the breast part of the chicken. I got my chicken here. That goes into my naanchi. I'm gonna take more chicken. That's a decent piece. Put that in, then I take some chippies. So I'm like, it's almost like I'm making my own potty wrap. And then what I do nicely, I just sprinkle my lemon onto my, you know, my naan bread, my chips, and my Tikka Chicken. I'm gonna sprinkle it over my chicken as well, and my chips. Maybe I put over my naan there as well. All right, I'm ready. I'm gonna take a massive bite of this. But before I do, moving forward, there is some surprises and some big things that's gonna happen with Grilled as a whole, as well as with Stepik. Here we go. Hi there, hope you're keeping well. Got the bone. Very cool, my sake. Naan bread is a bit chewy, elasticy. Flavor of the garlic in there is brilliant though. And just the chicken with the chips, lovely as well. So I don't know, you guys like your naan breads like this? The chicken. It's nice and spicy. It has a nice kick. The chicken is cooked perfectly. It's not like dry, droe, kowarige stories. It's well cooked. Chips. Chips is alright. Slap. Topped with some spice. Arshad, thank you very much. Lovely sauced and spiced chicken. Next up, we are going to review Ali from Repulse Road. Okay guys, next up, we've got Ali's from Repulse Road, quarter chicken and chips. Oops, I left the roll on top because if I had to leave it inside, it would not close. This is Ali's from Repulse Road. First glance, saucy as hell. Totally different to the Arshad smell. That I can tell you. They said, no, they don't do garlic naans. They do rolls. Here we go, you can have a look how like a saucy that is. Hello. Bye-bye. Yo guys. This is more of a like a garlicky flavor. Nice thick chip with the sauce on as well. Chicken breaks off beautifully. Then I'm busy with a saucy bird over here, so it's... So, I'll take my roll. Loaded chips. Chicken is also cooked nicely. Not dry. There you go, a nicely cooked piece on here. Sprinkle. Over my chicken, over my chips, over my roll there. So here we have it. We're gonna call this the Ninja Turtle Sandwich. You know what I'm saying? Let me just go back on it. Another bone. Eating the roll with the chicken and the chips on, the chips comes through more than the chicken, but as it goes and as it gets around, creates like its own biological environment in my mouth, like her own ecosystem. These chips are quite, like they're big cut. Chips are spiced and sauced as well, so it's flavorful as hell. The tikka chicken, the garlicky and the tikka-ness and the lemoniness, like chases after it immediately. Like if I compare it to our side, this is not spicy at all. It's almost modest, like being very modest, you know what I mean? I would have liked the garlic mayonnaise as well. Let's rate them out of 10 when I come back, and then you guys can give your opinion as well and all your experiences with tikka chickens. Arshad's in Rylands, Ruth Road versus Ali's in Repulse Road. Tikka chicken. Arshad in Rylands, thank you so much. Enjoyed it. We're going to give you 7.2 out of 10 today. Thank you very darn. Ali, we're going to give a 7.3 out of 10 today. Ali takes it. So thank you very much, guys. Please let me know your opinion. Let me know your experience with tikka chicken around Cape Town. The key guide for this weekend of our independent restaurateurs and eateries that are going to be open. If you guys don't feel like cooking, remember, if you do cook, send me pics. Send it to my DM or like post it and tag me so I can share it as well for you. They got Side Wing is doing beautiful burgers and their wings as well. The Grillmeister as well, they're in Penland. They're doing some burgers. They got some fire wings that they're gonna be doing this weekend. Then we've got Cut In Two. They sent us some quality pulled pork buns in the weekend. It was so super sweet and smoky and delicious and juicy. Got the Shack Grill and Go, they're in Otley as well. Burgers, pizzas, ribs, wings, crumb mushrooms, platters. Hit me up so we can also add them to the Geek Guide. Cape to Curry as well, Golden Dish as well. GoBinge.co.za. Steakbeg Instagram, Steakbeg Facebook, like, subscribe, share, you know the deal, you know the drill, you know how it goes in the streets of Sirrid. Say those, your vice. Have a brilliant weekend, and remember, be safe, wear your mask, sanitize, keep well, eh?